Hello everyone, happy new year once again. I am Brother Hosanna David. I want to share with us another vision that I had on the 27th of December 2019. It was the same period, the same time that I had a vision of the Christian club that people were inside, and then the rapture took place outside, and they were not even aware that Jesus Christ had returned to take his people home. I thank God for what the Lord is doing today and for this ministry that the Lord has given to me, Eagle Eye Opener Global Outreach, that is reaching the world with the message of truth. And not just that, the Lord Jesus Christ, since I have been in this ministry, online ministry, the Lord has been helping me and releasing messages so that his children can hear his voice, so that they can change from bad to good. Now, after having a vision where I actually saw the Christian club, and then followed by the rapture that took place, I saw myself in another vision. I saw myself in a church. I saw myself in a church. The service was on. And what I noticed is that in that service, I was standing with some persons, and my voice was very deep. It was not clear because I just finished screaming to people and screaming and warning people about the rapture. I was so serious. I was shouting at the top of my voice. That was so serious and warning people with so much seriousness. I was screaming to the extent that my voice became blocked. And while I was in church, I discovered that my voice was not clear, and it was like, at that moment, I couldn't speak loud for people to actually hear me well because I just finished screaming. The Bible says that as it were in the days of Noah, as it was, Matthew chapter 24, it's going to be another time again when people shall be going about their normal duties, people shall be going about their normal activities, and people shall be given in marriage and receiving in marriage. There shall be people who are going to be saying, peace, peace, that nothing is coming upon us. The world is so secure. There is nothing to fear. There are going to be people who are going to tell us that the Lord Jesus Christ is not coming again. Just as there were people who were telling those people in the time of Noah that, look at the world, who says that God is going to destroy this world? Everything is running normally. The morning comes, the evening comes, the night falls. So who is bringing this false news? Noah is just disturbing himself. That is how some people say today. In fact, we've seen prominent ministers of God saying that the Lord Jesus Christ is not going to return again. I had another vision where the earth was tired of the evil that men were doing, and the earth was releasing a substance called Bermuda. I have done the video. It's going to go live this week by God's grace, or maybe next week. Bermuda, the earth was tired. The Lord has been revealing the end time, giving people end time revelations, warning people that the earth is definitely going to come to an end. But a lot of people don't want to believe. A lot of people don't want to hear. A lot of people, because of some people believe, but they don't want to sacrifice what they are getting from those people and warn them. This is not the first time. Even at the time of Jeremiah, when Jeremiah spoke by the Lord, by the Spirit of the Lord, released prophecies that this nation is going to go to exile. Stop rebelling against the Lord. How many of them listened? But at the end, they saw it. But you know that in the time of Jeremiah, there were people who were telling these people that It is not going to happen that the Lord Jesus, I mean, that the Lord God of Israel is going to deliver them. And there were so much lies, prophets deceiving those people. I don't know who is watching right now, but I know definitely that there are deceivers out there, even fellow Christians, who tell you that once you are saved, you are always saved. Please, there are a lot of people are deceiving, but there are still few watchmen all over the world who are screaming at the top of their voices, screaming the truth, telling people to repent, because there is no more time. The Lord Jesus Christ is coming very, very soon. The Lord has been revealing this, and it has escalated. The frequency has increased. The Lord is calling his people to repentance. And I know that definitely the Lord Jesus Christ is going to return again. It is very, very soon. In the vision of the Christian Club, which I have posted on Eagle Eye Opener, the vision of the Christian Club, I saw that the rapture took place and people were not aware. And what the Lord told me is that there is urgent need to tell people to make awareness about the rapture. Please don't seal your mouth. The world is going to come to an end very, very soon. Jerusalem is a world clock. It's a world clock. Jerusalem is a clock. Jerusalem is a clock. We look at Jerusalem and we look at the happenings around Jerusalem, around Israel, I mean the nation of Israel, especially the temple as we speak now. The third temple is almost, the ivory plant is getting ready already. So let us know that the end is now. The very end is now. Do not be deceived. And I want to assure you that if you give your life to Jesus Christ and you're ready to follow him, the Lord Jesus will give you all the support that you need to follow him. He supplies the grace. Paul says that in 2 Corinthians, that when I am weak, then I am strong, because your strength is made perfect in weakness. Some of us, we look at our lives and we say, but I'm a sinner. I'm not holy. Listen, the Lord Jesus Christ is not calling holy people. They are already holy. The Lord Jesus Christ is calling sinners to himself. He's calling the prostitutes. He's calling the criminals. He's calling the assassins. He's calling all the people who do people. He's calling all witches and wizards to come to repentance. Jesus Christ never came to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. That is what he came for. So if you are watching this and you are a sinner, or you have given your life to Christ but you are not doing well, this message is for you. Congratulations, because the Lord Jesus Christ is calling you in particular to repentance. Give your life to Jesus Christ and forsake your evil ways. All you just need to do is surrender your life to Jesus Christ. And as you repent and give your life to Christ, he will supply all the grace and all the mercy that you need to forge ahead. Remember that by strength, no man prevails. It is not by strength. I am running a Christian race for decades now, and I know it is not by human strength. There were times I used my strength and I failed. But when you throw yourself upon the grace and the mercy of the Lord, he supplies the grace in the time of need. Do not be afraid that when you give your life to Christ, you won't enjoy your life again. Me, I have been living my life for Christ, and I tell you, for some years now, I have never experienced sorrow in my life. I'm not talking about not experiencing bad things or experiencing a sad moment, but I'm talking about sorrowing, sitting down and sorrowing. I'm talking about years. And I have now come to understand why the Lord says that the peace of God that passes all understanding will guard your hearts. I have experienced the peace of Christ. I have experienced joy, constant joy that the Holy Spirit gives. I have experienced a lot of failures, a lot of disappointments, but they never touched my heart. And I know the true meaning of what the Bible says, Proverbs chapter 3, verse 4, verse 23, 3:24, something, either of these two, that Guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Now I know that the Holy Spirit has a way. If we give him the chance, the opportunity, he will guard our heart against sorrow, against sadness. No matter what we feel, no matter what we face, no matter what we come across, he will guard our hearts and we will always experience joy. Why am I explaining this? Some of you feel that when you give your life to Jesus Christ, when you no longer drink, when you no longer smoke, when you no longer sleep around with women or men, you are going to lose your source of joy. No, joy never comes from all those things. Pleasure gives happiness, but pleasure, worldly pleasure, will never give you joy. It is in Christ Jesus that we can find complete joy and peace. If you are struggling, probably you've given your life to Christ and you're struggling, you're not happy, you are always looking backward, it is maybe you are still worrying about the things of this life. If you cast your cares upon Jesus Christ and you truly give your life to Christ, the peace of God must always I just see the comment, somebody said, let's stop bashing the false prophets. We continue to bash them because they are leading people to hell. We will not keep quiet. We will continue to bash the false prophets because they are dangerous to the kingdom of God. They are leading people to hell. They are thorns in the flesh of the church. So our job is to expose them. Our job is to make sure that those who have been deceived are brought to the light of the truth of God's word. Stop worrying about your life. Give your life to Jesus Christ, and the love of God will be shed abroad in your heart. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to visit our website, eagleeyeopener.com and biblicalsexualpurity.com. If you want to support the needy, you can visit hdfng.org. Hosanna David Foundation. Thank you, even as we make our world a beautiful place and help the poor and the needy and those on the street. And I also want to tell you, anytime you go out, remember the poor on the street, those who have nothing to eat, those who are homeless, please remember them. And don't forget that whatsoever thing you do for these ones who have nothing to eat, who have nothing, no place to stay, who are being killed by cold, excess cold, whatsoever thing you do for them, any bottle of water you give to them, you are also helping. In the name of the Lord, if you do it in the name of the Lord, and especially if you do it in the name of the Lord, you are going to receive your reward. And whatsoever thing you do, and people praise God, it will be counted for you as righteousness. Thank you, this brother who says, I was a false prophet. Thank you for being, thank you. You said you were a false prophet. Thank you for repenting and for knowing the truth. And I encourage you to continue the truth. Thank you for watching. Once again, I am Hosanna David. Do me a favor, share this video. Share our videos for people to know the truth. God bless you. Bye-bye.